Now, in some applications, you might have the need for many small scans instead of one large scan. We've said before that when you launch a kernel on a GPU, you want to have lots of work to do in that kernel, so it doesn't make a lot of sense to launch a scan kernel separately on each one of these small scans. Instead, we're going to pack these scans together as segments inside one big array, and then have a special scan operator that scans each of the segments independently. Typically, to indicate where segments begin in an array, we use a second array that has ones for segment heads and zeros for non-segment heads. Let's do an example. So if you'll recall, exclusive sum scan on an array simply takes the running sum of all elements that come before the current element. So the sum of all elements before 8, for instance, is 28. Now, what's different about a segmented scan is that we have a normal array, but what we do is we're marking with these large lines here boundaries between these segments. So when we call a segmented exclusive sum scan on this array, what it's going to do is take separate scans of each of these three segments. So the result is the scan of 1, 2, the scan of 3, 4, 5, and the scan of 6, 7, 8. And so the way that we're going to represent these segments is with segment heads, that we have a second array, the same length as the input array, that marks where segments begin. So a segment begins here with the number 1, a segment begins with the number 3, and a segment begins with the number 6. So to make sure we're on the same page, we're going to take the same array we did last time where we computed an exclusive segmented sum scan, and instead, you're going to fill in the result of an inclusive segmented sum scan on this input array. If you'll recall, an inclusive sum scan is going to be the sum of all elements that came before in the segment as well as the current element. So why don't you fill in these 8 boxes?